Okay, so they finally did it. Logitech has finally released the successor to the Logitech Brio 4K from 2016 or 2017. It's called the MX Brio. It's also 4K. It's called the 705 if you're in a business and buying this camera. Now we're going to see if this camera is better than the Logitech Brio 4K. You can see it looks quite a bit different. It feels pretty good. So we're going to test it with default settings, low light, as well as tune settings, and show you what I've set inside of Logitune and also the new Logitech Options Plus software. Let's go. First, what I want to show you are comparisons of both cameras and how they perform, both in default settings, in low light, also tuned, and also tuned in low light, and then the tuned settings that I've set for each camera using Logitune, and I'll also explain what's different about the Logitech Options Plus software that you can only use with the MX Brio and some of the other MX products from Logitech. All right, so this is the MX Brio's default image and also its default audio from the dual microphone array, just to see what it looks like and to hear what it sounds like as a standard UVC camera. I had to trim the microphone quite a bit, by the way, because it was clipping in its default levels. So I actually turned it down to about half of its normal output level in OBS just so it wouldn't clip on the recording. And I'm going to listen to what it sounds like, because I have a feeling that it was dangerously close to clipping even with it all the way turned down. All right, so that's the default image from the Logitech Brio MX with relatively good lighting. Let's have a look at the default image from the Logitech Brio 4K. All right, so this is the Logitech Ur Brio, the Brio 4K from 2017 with the updated firmware and everything on it, just so you can see what it looks like and also hear what it sounds like. It's already looking to me in the image preview that it's a little bit more on the yellower side, but it's letting in a whole lot more light by default. A lot of the blues are a bit more muted than they were on the MX Brio, but I still think I've got a little bit of that Simpsons-y kind of yellow skin going, so you can kind of see that. You need to dial that back out of the camera, and we're going to do that in a minute, but just so you can see what the Brio 4K looks like and hear what it sounds like. Okay, so now you've seen it with better lighting. Now let's go ahead and turn off all the lighting that's firing at me. I'll leave the lights on from behind, but you can see now what it looks like using the MX Brio. Now I'm in very low light in terms of seeing what the camera will do with default settings, just so you can see what it looks like and hear what it sounds like. The sound should be the same as before, but now I have no light firing at my face other than maybe the camera's little white light. And I've got some backlighting behind me, so I'm in less than ideal lighting conditions just to see how well this does in terms of graininess of the image and whether or not the noise suppression on the image itself is working to make the low light performance decent on the MX Brio.
Okay, so that was the default MX Brio. Now let's take a look at the default low light settings, same lights, same lighting on the Brio 4K from a few years ago.
Okay, so this is the Logitech Brio 4K, the Ur Brio in low light, just to see what it looks like and also hear what it sounds like. You can see it's not a great image, but just to compare it with the MX Brio with a larger sensor and different optics.
Okay, so now you've seen them in good lighting as well as low lighting, so you can see what the default behaviors look like as a standard UVC webcam without tuning anything. Let's go ahead and start to tune the images, and I'm going to start with the MX Brio.
All right, so this is the MX Brio with tuned settings in Logitune. Now, I did install the Logitech Options Plus software as well, and note they are the same exact settings in either app. The Logitune app is more for businesses as well as private individuals, whereas the MX app, basically for Logitech Options Plus, has more other controls for keyboards and other things also. It's kind of like a light version of G-Hub, so I would say if you tune the camera, I would tune it with Logitune because you have the same fidelity of options. Both will do firmware updates on the camera, as I found out, by the way, too. Now, just so you can see kind of what I've got set up for this camera, I have sharpness, I'll start from the bottom, at 140. I've got vibrance at 141, which is kind of close to how saturation works, by the way. I've got saturation turned down to 116, all the defaults were 128. And if I go up to contrast, it's at 139, so up about 11 there.
Brightness is at 96. There's something new with this camera, which is temperature compensation in addition to auto white balance. So you can have the auto white balance running, but basically compensate for the temperature. So I've actually added a bit more warmth to it. I've added 400 kelvins towards the warmer side of the spectrum. And then for auto exposure, there's some cool stuff here versus the other cameras. So sometimes you'll get exposure levels and gain. Now we've actually got shutter speed. I've got it at 1/60 because it's running at 4K 30 right now. And I have ISO at 500. Now, just like a normal camera, you can turn the ISO up and down. Usually, you know, normal camera recommendations, you try to go almost as low as you can on ISO without the image looking too dark, or at least that's what I do. And it actually looks pretty good. I think it looks fairly close to my DSLRs or mirrorless cameras. Not quite the amount of detail, but pretty good. Autofocus I left turned on, which seems to not hunt or anything. And as you might have experienced with the Logitech Brio 4K, HDR does very little for me, at least. When I turn it off here, it actually looks like quite a bit of difference. It looks like I've been using a lot of self-tanning lotion or something. So it goes quite a bit different in terms of the color. I think it still looks pretty good. I could probably dial it in from here, but I already have it dialed in for HDR. So I'll go ahead and go back to HDR. And you can see from a motion perspective, it's very smooth. Not a lot of motion blur or anything. So this is a pretty high quality sensor and optic stack and camera. Let me know what you think in the comments. All right, so now let's have a look at what the Brio 4K looks like with some tuning and optimization to it as well. Okay, so this is the Orbrio 4K with some image adjustments. It's from the 2017 model. I've got sharpness up a little bit to 152. Saturation is down to 84. Contrast, I have that up to 145, and I've got brightness at about 115. Now, I turned off the auto white balance because I can show you what it looks like when I turn it on. So right now it's at 4840 kelvins, which is about 5000 kelvins, which is more or less where my lights are at in terms of color temp. And I also turned off automatic exposure. I have HDR on, which doesn't seem to do a ton in terms of the effect of this particular camera. So I'll just turn off HDR and you'll see it changes a little tiny bit. So I'll put it back on. And now if I go down to auto exposure, let me turn that one on first. And you'll see that it makes things pretty bright, you know, which you wouldn't kind of doubt it for in terms of that. And then if I go to auto white balance, that's when things, you know, depending on your preference, it gets a bit yellower again. It took the white balance, I think, down to or up to a much higher number, maybe 6,000 kelvins or something. But just to show you what the defaults look like again, if I set the image, now I'm back in Oompa Loompa land, Homer Simpson world. And so that's what the default settings do to the image once I set that.
Okay, so let's torture test these cameras a little bit. Now let's go with tuned settings, but low light using the Brio MX.
Okay, so this is the MX Brio camera, low light with the same settings that we saw before with its built-in microphone. Just so you can see what it looks like with low light. I think it's actually pretty impressive in low light. Getting a little bit of light flicker with the frequency of my LEDs that are still kind of hitting me from the sides here. But it's actually looking pretty good in low light in terms of not having too much noise. Let me know what you think.
All right, so same thing. Let's look at low light tune settings from the Logitech Brio 4K from a few years ago.
Okay, and just for comparison's sake, this is the Logitech Brio 4K, the Orbrio, at low light with the same settings that I set with the tune settings in the Logitune app, just so you can see what it looks like with no lighting firing at my face, and so you can kind of gauge the amount of noise in the image itself.
Okay, so pretty big difference in terms of kind of the way the default images work, as well as the different controls that you have for both cameras. I really gotta say, I like the MX Brio in terms of the additional granularity of control that you have with things like the ability to do temperature correction or compensation, the ability to set up things like shutter speed and ISO. Now, one of the big omissions, though, I think for me at least, being very close to Windows, is that
The Windows Hello biometric authentication is no longer in the MX Brio. I would say, though, in terms of the image quality, and especially like things like the HDR and the additional settings, the MX Brio is by far the best Logitech camera out now in terms of USB webcams. It probably has a lot of the tech that went into, say, some of the Logitech Teams room systems, those types of things. The 8.5 megapixel sensor, nobody from Logitech actually gives out the sensor size, but it's got to be a larger sensor, a nice optic stack. Of course, it works with things like Microsoft Teams as Teams certified. So it's a great choice for business and for private use. So I would say it's the best static frame camera out there. I didn't talk to all the different things it can do in terms of show mode and being able to tilt it down, but it has that high friction foot on it. It's got a lot more adjustability in terms of how it can be adjusted with its mount. It also has the ability to use quarter 20 if you're going to mount it, say, in a meeting room or something, or on a tripod. And in terms of fit and finish, I would say just the materials on the MX Brio being more or less aluminum. I've got the charcoal gray one here with a nice anodized aluminum finish. It's all using recycled plastics. Those feel really good. The quality, the feel, the weighting, the way the hinge works, it just feels like a much nicer unit than the Brio 4K does, which I would say did feel like a very quality unit back when it was new in 2016 or 2017. But now it's feeling a little bit dated. The privacy shutter being built into the MX Brio is a nice thing to have. So I would recommend this camera. Hopefully this helps you as you make your camera purchasing decisions. I didn't go through all the different specs, but I will show some of those on the screen in terms of what it can do. It can also do things like 1080p 60 like the Brio 4K could, 4K 30 like I filmed this entire show in. So you can see exactly kind of what the camera is capable of. All right, so hopefully this helps in terms of buying your next webcam. By the way, if you haven't looked at all the different new Logitech Brio options, check out the video on the screen. I go through all the new ones, the 500, 300, and 100 series, and how those compare to the Logitech Brio 4K. So don't miss that. We'll see you next time, and thank you so much for watching.